word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Jesus was coming. She went to meet him. But Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you. Jesus said to her, your brother will rise. Martha said, I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day. Jesus told her, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this? She said to him, yes, I have come to believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. I never knew your mother during her life. I've learned a bit about her these past few days. And I do know that we share a common faith, a common baptism, part of the same body of Christ. And that means a lot. That's what our life is about, being united. God just told us how important that life was to her, that faith, as she lived so fully and shared with so many. I think of those words that Martha said to Jesus. They were not easy. They were born of pain, a pain that we've all experienced and you're experiencing now. She said, Lord, if you'd been here, my brother would not have died. It's that simple. You might be echoing those words. Lord, if you'd been here, she wouldn't have died. And yet, she moved into that fuller life that we've been promised. That life into which she was baptized, into which we were baptized. That life we say we believe, and Martha was so honest, she said, I've come to believe. We continually come to believe that Christ is our life. That we're born to journey through this world into eternity. And that's something beyond our understanding, which is where our faith comes. Do believe that there's more to life than what we know today. There's more to life than this part of our journey. And Peg knew that. She knew that her faith was leading her on a journey through this life, more fully into God's kingdom. And in the midst of this journey, she shared that love of God with all of you and so many others. That love that she herself experienced, no doubt through so many people, in so many ways, and perhaps most particularly and fully in the life she shared with her father. That marriage that reflected Christ's love for us. That love that they reflected onto the world, into your lives. It's that love that doesn't end. It's that love that brings so much pain, such great loss, but has also brought to each of you such great life and laughter and wonderful. St. Paul was so aware that life can change so quickly, in an instant, in the blink of an eye. And you've experienced that, and the pain of that. We journey through it, continuing our own lives, knowing that. We continue to live each day fully in the Lord, faithfully following the gospel we proclaim. Trusting, as Isaiah tells us, that the Lord continually will provide for all peoples, here and now, and in that kingdom where Jesus truly is Lord, forever and ever. Having listened together to the Word of God, we now open our hearts in prayer for one another, for Peg, for all of God's people.
It was fine. O Lord, be our strength.
O Lord, be our strength.
For God's people throughout the world, that we may continue to care deeply for one another, we pray.
O Lord, be our strength.
For all heads of state, that they may always strive to serve the common good and promote human dignity and justice, we pray.
O Lord, be our strength.
For all who are sick and suffering, and for those who care for them, we pray.
O Lord, be our strength.
For Peg, whose funeral we now celebrate, she may share fully in the resurrection of Christ, we pray.
O Lord, be our strength.
For all of us gathered here in faith, that we may be consoled by the peace Christ promises, we pray.
O Lord, be our strength. O Lord, our God, be our strength this day. Be our strength always, through Christ our risen Lord. Please be seated.
Number 630 in our new hymnals is where you will find our presentation song today. Let us sing together verses 1 and 4 of How Great Thou Art.
Consider all the works thy hands have done. Thank you.
which we now celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to the second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look upon this offering of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, her husband, with your apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints on this constant intercession in your presence. We rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, with the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own righteousness. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, David, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern his own glorious body. And to our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, where you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you our God as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. That by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, look on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord always be with you.
Take away the sins of the world and
invite everyone receiving communion this morning please to come forward in the center aisle in two lines and to return the side aisles.
Our communion hymn this morning is number 749, On Eagle's Wings.
Let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life, so as to open up and enter into eternity. We humbly beseech you that through the strength of this sacrament, you may command the name of your servant Peg to be inscribed in the Book of Life. Through Christ, our risen Lord. Trusting in God, we've prayed here together this morning for Peg. And now we come to that last farewell. We know that there's always sadness in parting. Yet we take comfort in the hope that one day we'll see Peg again, and you'll enjoy her friendship and love. Although today we disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us all together again, the joy of God's kingdom. Therefore, let us always console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Forgive whatever sin she may have committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant her everlasting peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace now, we take Peg to her place of rest.
Our final hymn this morning is number 754, Be Not Afraid.
I'm not wrong.